What's up, everybody? Today's 246 days into making Songbringer. It's actually officially a year now that I've been making this video game, but 246 days of development streamed. That's like 2 hours per stream times 250 days almost. That's like 500 hours of video so far gone into the making of this video game. Anyways, today's goal is kind of ambitious. My goal is to make 4 different enemies in one stream. Not draw them, mind you. That's going to take longer to actually give these enemies character and stuff like that. I'm just going to use some simple, like, whoa, I forgot we're in God mode. I'm just going to use some gray boxes and stuff to represent these enemies for the moment. So, I'm not actually going to do the entire enemy, but if I can get the behavior done for 4 enemies in one stream, that will be quite significant. It'll make me feel pretty good, too, like progress-wise. Alright, so, let's start doing it. We need 4 different enemies. Let's start just creating some profiles. I don't think there's any... Are there any constants to be changed? I don't think there are. That's good. That's a really good thing. And in general, you know, a constant is something that would require recompiling everything. So I'm glad that adding an enemy is not going to have to change a constant. That's good to know. Good to realize. What's up, Bit of Barney? Welcome to the stream, man. Here's a Zelda for you. I mean a Link, sorry. Okay, so starting with the profiles, I'm just going to call these A, B, C, D for now. Because I don't know what these, like I said, I'm not creating the actual visual or verbal identity or whatever for these enemies. Okay, yeah, we got A, B, C, D. 4 enemies we're doing today. B... Alright, I don't like it. I'm gonna do A. There, now I got them all together. Great. It's a little more simple. Okay, so the first enemy, actually let me outline what enemies we gonna create today. So that I don't get lost today. It's easy to get lost. There's so much code. So enemy A, this is the guy that bounces around the screen diagonally. Enemy AA, this will be double A. Single A is going to be, patrols a small area horizontally. Okay. Second guy bounces around the screen diagonally. Third guy patrols and shoots diagonal projectiles. 4 diagonal projectiles. Team Extreme. What's that? What's that referring to? So the last enemy is going to be one that hugs a certain, like, always stays near. Always stays near an edge, moving turning only to the left to stay near the edge, something like that. Just hugs an edge, basically. Okay, so those are the four enemies I want to do today. Just the behaviors. It's Franker faces, man. Franker faces. Nice, Sakuma. Right? I know it doesn't seem like much. You just programmed enough to get a sprite to move. I know that doesn't seem like much, but that can take weeks sometimes. So you should congratulate yourself, man. Celebrate this moment. That's amazing. You made a lot of progress. Seriously.
You're kind of dark in here. It's winter time.
It's going to be winter time. Lights fading sooner. Nice. Okay, yeah, let's start with the double A one, or the single A. This guy just patrols. Patrols a small area horizontally. Okay, so we can take, let's take the same art as the blob, I guess. Same attribute art, everything about the blob. Basically, this is a good place to start. Okay. Don't need the skins though. Animations, these are gonna be fine too. Don't need the skins though. Wait, it just says idle and release, that's it? These guys are really simple. I forgot how simple they are. Got a herd noise, release noise, good, good. Okay, so here's where we're gonna do the behavior differently. So let's first of all, we might need to put these guys in the game. Nice. Good, good, man. What's up, Overcaster? I'm working on creating four enemy behaviors in one stream. I've never ever done anything this ambitious before. So, you know, typically I'll go and I'll spend like a whole stream drawing an enemy. And then the next day I'll spend the whole stream making the behavior. Today I'm going to try and do four different behaviors in one stream. So I'm going to start with gray blocks for all these enemies. Or maybe just I'll start with the blob. Yeah, that's the goal for today. So this first enemy is a guy that patrols left and right. All he does is he walks to the left, stops, turns around, walks to the right, and back and forth. That's his only thing he does. And you know what? I'm thinking that maybe I should actually use a gray square for now for all these new enemies, just to make them look distinct from the blob. I shouldn't be using the blobs. Graphics for all that. So let's make a little square. It's about as big as the player. All right. So, what the heck? Okay, but not quite as tall as his whole head. So about that tall, about like this. This is the size of this gray square we want to create. And we'll give it a highlight on the top so it does look like it's some. What's up, Boogie? What up, bro? Today's four enemies in one stream. I'm trying to go as fast as I can. So that should be about a half an hour per enemy. And we'll give it one more little highlight edge. All Right, just kind of like do that to it so it doesn't look horrible. There. All right, we've got a gray square. We're going to do all these enemies are going to look like this at first. In fact, I'm not going to do any art for enemies. I'm just going to work on behaviors today. So let's get this exported and in the game and ready to go for forever. I'm going to keep this forever. Awesome, man. Cool idea. Yeah, what's up, Extreme? Jib, jib. What's up, Blood? Awesome, man. Isn't it fun to be in that phase of a game where you're designing everything like that? I love that phase. So creative, right? And that's what, it's really easy to get into that phase of the game. The difficult thing is completing the game, you know? Starting with those great ideas and seeing them all the way through. Very few people actually do that. Foes. Yeah, let's call this just default foe or whatever. Default foe. Yes, that graphic is going to be shipped with the game. Default foe. I have 11 mods. You mean mods of this chat? Not 11 mods currently. Doing good, man. How are you doing? Live and kicking? Default or whatever. Yes. Or whatever. I should have said over or whatever. Okay, anyways, let's get that in. Default foe. Okay, now let's hook him up into the foes. So that this little text right here is where it actually determines what enemies go where in the world. So let's create a bunch of these guys, right? We'll call it A1 is Z0 difficulty range of all of them. So it's not, we don't even need to worry about that, but we're gonna create some As, some single As, about, let's just do 4 of them for now. Okay, so then we're gonna have the and the four of all these. Nice, fail fast, very good. Nightbot's hardly a mod. No, I haven't made it, I haven't actually finished any enemies yet, but I'm making all behaviors today, no graphics, no art. I'm just going to work on 4 different behaviors for enemies. The 4 enemies I'm working on are 1, a guy that patrols a small area horizontally. 2, a guy that bounces around the screen diagonally. 3, a guy that patrols and shoots 4 diagonal projectiles. And the last one, a guy that always stays near an edge, turning to the left. So he like just hugs an edge. Like if there's some kind of little thing in the middle of the screen, he'll walk around and around and around it. That's the goal for today. Get all those behaviors done. You did. Nice, man. Yes, 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 exactly. Just one drawing a day to get used to shapes and coloring and stuff. Totally. Yeah, man. That's the path. You're on the way, dude. You're on the way. Yeah, nice. Right on, man. Cool. You started development today. Good for you. High five. Yeah, yes. Yes, it is. Okay, so this guy patrols small area horizontally. Let's get him working. Let's get to an area where we can test them out. So now we've got those different types of enemies in here. Let's, okay, wait. First of all, let's give this guy. This guy's gonna, let's give all these guys this stuff. Default behavior. So okay, now we're gonna work on this first guy. What is taking so long? Stop the build. Build again. You can go faster than that. What's wrong with you? Oh no, did I break something? What's it doing? It's processing the common texture packer sheet forever. Why? Nice, man. Right on. Oh, that's so good to hear. I'm glad. So glad. Remember all those extra credits videos when you're first getting started with video game development? Watch all those extra credit videos that I sent over. I'm not sure if I sent it to you, but if I didn't, I can send it again. What's up, TM? Welcome to the stream. Today is 4 enemies in 1 stream day. Okay, I don't know why that took so long. In fact, that kind of worried me. I want to check out the common list of sprites. Make sure nothing broke. Looks like it maybe just got bigger. That one single ping file made it get huge. I think that's what might have happened there. Okay, so now you run the game, and we can see what areas are going to have those 4 enemies, where it randomly placed those types of enemies. Then we can walk around and... Alright, so right here's some of them. Who knows what the heck? It's so funny. I love seeing these gray squares. Okay. So what was that guy, right? Whoa, who was that? I should have made one blue and one green or red or something. You watched all of them? Sweet. Oh, that's so rad. Yeah, man. Yes, dude, yes. It's funny, dude. I like it. But you know what? You're getting used to it, right? You get used to the pen. You get used to lines, shading, and things like that. This is really not that bad of a piece of art, right? I know you must feel like when you first start making art, you feel like sometimes your art is not that great. But really for the first step, you know, or two, this is not that bad. So good job, man. And the more you do it, you're just gonna get better and better and better. A wild cinder block appears. It's totally a wild cinder block. That's actually a funny name for an enemy. Wild cinder block. Okay, right near the start, we got to the left. 800 has a single A1. Okay, so let's go to 800. 8007509. Right? Okay, so these are the single A's. Okay, so now the goal is to make these guys simply just patrol an area horizontally. So let's start writing the behavior for that. Okay, so they first of all need an impulse. They just start moving. They never have a target. These guys never have a target. These are really dumb enemies. They're very, very beginner enemies, you know what I mean? So, basically, if the timer is up, we're going to start an impulse or start moving. If the timer is less than 0, face the opposite direction. Or we can do a select. So we go select. If rand what would be the, like, if rand 0.0 0.05. No, this is if we don't have a direction already. Shoot. Okay, so how to get him to go like randomly? I'm trying to think of how to get him to randomly start to the either work walking to the left, or they start walking to the right. Oh. Okay, first thing, let's get them so they have move flags, so they can only move to the left or the right. Who has their movement locked already? Drop. Oh yeah, the drops boss. Allow input. Here we go. Okay, so these guys. First thing, allow input only east and west. These random cinder blocks. A wild cinder block. Such a good word. Dude, wild. Okay, wait. I got it. If we can give them an initial direction, actually. So sequence. If target none, target nearest friend, and then also give it a direction. So Durand, there. So that'll give it a random direction, either east or west. And now all we gotta do is start the impulse, the movement. Timer's less than zero. We want to face the opposite direction. That's really all it is to this whole AI. That might need to be a Durand there. All right, we'll see what we got now. Wait, face opposite. I'm not sure if that's actually valid. No, it's not. They're like, yeah, here we go. I'm a wild cinder block. I'm a jittery wild cinder block. I think it's just dur-ops is the word. Ooh, it's getting windy out there. It might get some more rain. Oh, look at that! Now they're even more jittery. Okay, the point is to give them a timer, right? If the timer's less than zero, we do the opposite direction and set a timer. So timer one. Or delay, we could just delay. We'll do timer first. Timer one, either one. If we do stuck or start, this will probably be Durand actually. Dude, winter is coming because they're shivering. They're wild. They're out in the wild. They're just cinder blocks. They have no fur. Nothing to keep them warm? No friends to... Hey, it's working. Yay! Alright. That's kind of cheesy, right? With just seeing a wild cinder block like that. But that's a complete AI right there. It's pretty much done. All I gotta do is slap on some art. Call it good! That's pretty awesome. Okay, how long did that take to do one enemy and do the prep work for three others? 24 minutes, dude. I've been a jerk, I could do eight in one stream sometime. Maybe next stream we'll do 8 enemies in one stream. Can I set the timer random? Maybe. No, not yet. That's something I intend to add. So it would be something like this. Timer 1.0 plus R or something like that. I haven't actually programmed that in yet. But that is a very cool thing to add, right? Random timer. Right? Okay, so yeah, this is a good, very good thought, but not the purpose of today's stream. Today's stream is not to work for very long on any one of these enemies. It's just to simply get their behavior started so that I feel sort of a sense of progress. You know what I mean? I feel like I've been ignoring enemies for too long. Yeah, it definitely would be cool. So I will do that. Yeah, timer rand. It could be a timer rand. Actually, yeah, that's probably a better idea, huh? Timer rand like 1.0 or timer rand 2.0 or something like that. It just does 0 to that. Or timer rand 1.0. Yeah, it's good to make it a range like that, 1 to 2. Yeah, that I like, but even better. That's a better way to word it. So, okay. Let me keep that as a comment for now. So I remember to do that later. Yeah. Yes, yeah, yeah. This is a behavior tree. You can look up articles on that, behavior trees. And it's inspired by one article I read. But the basic concept of behavior trees is not any different than what I've used. It's a very simple thing. All it does is you got these selects, you got these sequences, and then you got a bunch of different commands. Every one of the AI in this game uses these behavior trees. Even things like butterflies use a behavior tree. Oh, in fact, the butterfly is a really good example for how to do the diagonal moving enemy. Nice. Okay, let's get on to the next enemy. Got A done. Double A is the one that bounces around the screen diagonally. Okay, so this bouncing guy, much like a butterfly. Butterflies have their move. Oh, weird. Oh, I thought they had diagonal movement only, but they don't. Okay. But anyways, this guy will. So we allow the input northwest, northeast, southwest, southeast. Okay, and then their behavior should be similar to this. Oh, I just thought of how we could give it a timer that gets random a little bit in these guys. Timer is less than 0, and if timer rand 0.5. So that'll add a little bit of a random element of chance whether it's going to run this or not. And we can make it, instead of 1.0, we can make it like 1.1 or something, and that'll really... Right? See, now they're a little more random. In fact, I think I want them to be a little less random, so let's do 3 there, and 1, 1, 1 there. We'll do 1, 2, 2 here, or maybe less, actually 0.9 there. There, that looks... Yeah, right? It's kind of the same thing. This would be better, though. I'd rather do this kind of command. Let's have something more specific, right? I do love having a very nice, simple... like, you know, way to do things. Like, I like it if something had, like, this has only one way of doing something, but this is something specific. Okay, so let's get on to this next guy, the diagonal guy. He's gonna be like this, kind of. Okay, so if dir none, dir rand. Oh, duh. That's how I could have done this other guy like that. Okay, but anyways. If dir none, dir rand, sequence change, this is where he's going to change his direction. But we don't want to do that. There's no changing. I just wanted to bounce off of edges. If position, edge, dir, opposite. Actually, if I want to, I just want to go if stuck, dir opposite, and no pathfinding. Right? I think that's how it goes. Pathfinding. No? That's not it. K move pathfinding. Oh man, I wish this was hooked up. It's not yet. Yeah, that's because he was walking along the edge. That's because he was using pathfinding. So I'll add that feature so we can turn off pathfinding. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Welcome to the stream today. Today's four enemies in one day stream. Ambitious, hopefully. But not the visuals. It's not art. It's just the behaviors of these enemies. So that should make it possible. Area boundary, pathfind. Oh, there is a pathfind flag. What is it? Where did you get it from? I thought this was already in here. Pathfind, get bull, pathfind? Pathfind. So yeah, let's turn this guy off. Pathfind, zero. And this one too. This guy's pathfind, zero. But we're going to start with this first guy, and let's watch him again. That one guy that got going along the edge, going upwards, that shouldn't happen now. He should do no pathfinding, which means if he hits an edge, he'll just stop at it. I think he's hitting that edge, actually. Yeah, he's hitting the edge, because enemies can never walk all the way to the edge. They can only hit within one square, one tile, or one block of the edge. So good, there we go. That guy's kind of a little more fixed, a little more better. Now let's get to the second guy. Where would he be? We put a couple double A. There's one. 14, 3, 0. Could I look at this? Of course. What do you want me to look at? What do you want me to look at, man? All right, 14-3, double A. This guy should bounce around the screen. I didn't even finish his AI yet, though. Okay, here's one of them. Oh, they need to start in the middle, though, for these guys. Is a way to do that. So there's two types of entrances for foes. One, they can walk in off the screen, or two, they can start on the screen. These guys need to start on the screen. Toby Peters, what's up, man? Welcome to the stream again. Or welcome back. Why can't they go to the edge? Because there's lots of problems with them, with enemies getting near the edge. And it's primarily if you kill an enemy and they drop an item, and then you go and you try and pick up the item, you accidentally will walk off the edge. That's one reason. But I guess that's the main reason. Yeah. So what was that? There's a way to set flags, I think. Add flag. Flags waterfall, as I think it's called set flag? No, set pattern. We have set pattern, but not set flag. Oh, is this worth hooking up right now? Maybe. Yeah. So that's the reason for now. I think there's a few other reasons. I just can't really remember them right now. Sorry, ma'am. I don't know if I can click on this one. Does this have music in it? Set pattern. Let's see how difficult that would be to add another flag thingy. Set pattern. Not you. These. Pass pattern, set pattern. Now this is gonna take a minute. Okay, so we need to do a set pattern. In fact, I'm gonna take note of that by adding a comment to the behavior tree. This guy needs set a flag. Not entrance B, something like that. Yeah, so this is going to be kind of more involved than I can accomplish in a half an hour. So let's find another area where these guys are going to be living for now, and hopefully it doesn't have that flag which makes them start off the screen. Here's another one, 310. Let's try that. No. Flags, yeah, flags is checking for a flag. I need a setting called set flag, and it's really easy to hook that up, but it's gonna take me probably 15 minutes to do that, and there's not enough time to do four enemies in this one stream, behaviors and that. So I can't really click on that without maybe incurring a copyright issue. So, but I can maybe watch it later. Okay, let's see if that is an area that's going to work for this guy. What's up? Looks like it hanged. It hunged. The game is hung. Oh, once again, they're starting off the edge. All right, so let's find another area. There's one, 15-2-0. Here's crossing my fingers. Damn, every one of these. Okay, you know what? I got a way easier way to do this. Instead, I already know that at 800. We have the first guys. So let's change the first guys to be the second guys. And we don't have to deal with just trying to find another area thing. So this guy's double A, sure, but this guy's also double A for now. Do I use a finite state machine for the AI? Yes, it's a subset of a finite state machine called a behavior tree. I think. I might be wrong about that. I'm not exactly sure on those terms, but I'm pretty sure when I was researching behavior trees that they are a subset of state machines. How is the progress so far? Are you talking about this stream? This stream where I'm on the second enemy and I've been streaming for 38 minutes, so good, doing good on the progress. It looks like that guy was working, but I haven't checked his AI yet, so. If dir is none, dir rand, sequence bounce if stuck, dir opposite. Yeah, that's all this AI needs. All he does is bounce around the screen diagonally. Oh, nice. They bounce with each other, too. Boom. All right. Cool. That guy's done. Sweet, that was like a 10-minute enemy. Yeah. Yeah, that's a good idea. That's a good idea. I like that. Yeah. Kind of goes with the theme of last week, trying to do better debugging tools. Yeah. Okay, dude, this guy's done. Next enemy. Heck, man, if there's enough time, I could start doing some art for these guys, too. All right, this one is going to be the AAA guy. The AAA guy, who the hell is this? He patrols and shoots four diagonal projectiles. We can do this. Okay, so the patrolling guy, look, his AI looks like this. Start with that. The guy that shoots something that's kind of similar. It would be the darts and the drolly guy. Drolly has something where he launches. Right, here's his launch animation where he shoots the darts. Oh, that's one way to do it too, right? X and or Y changing. Good thoughts, good thoughts. Okay. If target in a line, no. We don't really need that either. Shoot. Ran smart. No, let's not do smarts on this one either. Rando 06. Yeah, that's a good way to start, but so that gives it a chance. It rolls a random number between 0 and 1.0, and if that is less than 0.6, I think, no, something like that. If the target is far away, we don't want that either, really. We don't want to change this thing's direction. We don't want to face the direction of the target either. We just want to launch our projectiles. In fact, we can even start with the dart for now. Animate, maybe. Don't reset. Actually, yeah, we do want to set dir none. Yeah, so we can have initial target for this guy and also an initial direction phase. So initial direction. This is if dir none. And this guy is if target none, target something. So there, it gives it a target if it's got none. This one gives it a direction if it's got none. We want to make sure this guy only moves. Allow input east and west. Yeah, I know, right? Yeah. That's why I'm taking all your thoughts as, yes, I would love to do that later on today, but not for right now. So yeah, I got to stay focused on this stream. This is a highly ambitious goal. What up? Oh, I love the slot. Okay, so that makes him turn around. This one is if he gets stuck, he does some random direction. This is when he shoots and delays everything, so he stops completely for a moment. All right, let's try him out. This should be the right area because I changed the foes. Yeah, we got AAA. All right, see what happens. He's not gonna shoot diagonally just yet, but he will shoot something, I think. Yeah, oh yeah, they're just shooting. Nice. They're definitely shooting a bit too much though. If they're gonna have these darts that can shoot out diagonally in four different directions, he should do it less often. So let's at least double that to 1.2. All right, next thing, let's make it so this dart moves. Let's make a copy of the dart. And make this dart so it moves diagonally. Call it AAA's shot. And AAA shot. Actually, I'm not sure if this guy should shoot in four different directions at once. Maybe just one direction at once. I'm not sure if this will work doing the allow input. Let's see if it does. Okay, so this guy is now going to shoot the AAA shot instead of the dart. Yeah, see, looks something's broken with these guys. I think it might be this allow input. So if I turn that off, oh wow, look at that! It just worked all of a sudden, sort of. Yeah, some of those are diagonal. Oh, because they're moving in a diagonal direction. Oh, he got me! And it works. That's cool. I'm using a MacBook Pro 2013 Retina. It's got a solid-state drive. It's rad. It's a pretty good system, but it does overheat easily. And secondly, it's not that great for gaming because almost every game today is 3D and makes your fan and GPU work really hard. So, yeah. All right, you know what? This guy's pretty much done too. All he does is he patrols a little bit. Wait, what's this? Dir opposite? Yeah, that's right. Dir none. Ah, yeah, this guy's fine. Oh, wait, I wanted this guy to move. Oh. I didn't want this guy to move by actually diagonally. I just wanted him to move horizontally and then shoot. Oh, see, this is something where it would need some special AI. Yeah, it's a chip off the old Bert. They are. They got to be related. Oh, my God. We have to write some backstory for all this. The Berts. The Berts and their little cinder block friends. Okay, you know what? This is another thing I'm going to have to take a note for this and do this later. So I like it when he's got this allow input east-west. That's cool, but wait, hold on a second. These guys are supposed to move diagonally. Or wait, they're supposed to move in any direction. Oh yeah, they do move in any direction. Okay. So this guy had the allow input of northwest, northeast, southwest, southeast. Then he would be a right for this AI, sort of. Okay, so I want to make it so, let's take another note. Make it so a projectile can fire in a different direction than the enemy is facing. Or I guess you could do a like a different face direction command that allows setting allow input on the same line, blah, 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 you know what I mean? Something like that. That could be two, right? One and all, like four different shots, right? Shoot. Yeah, that could work too. And this, oh, you know what? This would be one way to do it. If I wanted to do all four of them at once, I could just do that exact technique right there. but putting zero delay between them. Really cool. Thanks, Toby. Good thought. That could work. Okay, so now I think this guy is going to be done enough for now for this whole rapid rapid prototyping. I guess this is kind of rapid prototyping of enemies. Cool. Yeah, those guys are good enough for now. Let's do the last guy. Okay, so the last guy is a guy that always stays on the edge. Yeah, he always like walks, like if he was next to a certain rock or whatever, he would always walk around and around and around that rock. This guy could be difficult actually to create with today's system. I'm not sure how I'm gonna do this with the behavior trees as they are. So, but let's start anyways. First the foes, make it so this guy is now that guy. Okay, so how to create an AI where he always keeps a collision entity on his left. Huh. Well, first of all, he'll need the allow input to be east, west, north, south. So only four directions. The second thing, I'm thinking that it might be as simple as just setting him loose. If he's got these directions and he can pathfind. So if dir none, dir rand. Let's see what happens there. If dir, right? Yeah, that would be a nice statement to add, right? If, yeah, you can't. I can do if dir. Oh, so he gets stuck when he gets all the way to the corner. Oh, I got it. All we need is if stuck. If stuck, dir like plus one or something like that, you know? So if you're going east, you would now be going south or whatever. And then minus one would be north. This maybe an easier way to represent this should be dir next or dir previous. Yeah, this could work. They're building a house. Yeah. Yeah, that would be one way to do it too, right? Oh my gosh, maybe that would work. Actually, you're right. So, okay, instead of these, let's try that. That could work. Okay, man, you're so creative. Thank you, man. If dir north. Wait, no, this needs to be a select. Select. If dir north. Dir east. Now we just do a bunch of. Oh. Wait. Select. This is a sequence. This is kind of long to write that same thing, but this would work, and I wouldn't have to create another system or whatever. So if dir east, you would be going south. If dir south, you'd be going west. If dir west, you'd be going north. Let's hope this works, because this would be cool. Yeah, it is kind of long, right? Hey, what's up, DuPont? Ah, what happened? Okay, so it broke on one of the behaviors. Invalid behavior if der north doesn't like n. Maybe n is not one of the directions, but it should be n. Yeah, it has n. Select me. Okay, so select means run. Select means run one of these. It goes through each one of them, and if it can do that, then it chooses this one, right? Sequence is the almost the exact opposite. Sequence will run through every single one of the things inside the sequence until it fails. So select chooses one. So if this one, if anything in this block fails, then it will go on to try the next one, and then try the next one, and then try the next one. That's what a select does. Is it like an else though? Yeah. It totally should be fine. There's no need for an else here, because what this does is it runs it if only if he's stuck, right? So if he gets stuck, he goes, all right, what's my next direction? It chooses that next direction, and that's it for that frame. So it allows a whole frame to go by, so movement happens if possible. And then if he's still stuck, then he chooses another direction. So he's not just gonna spin. So yeah. But what happened with that? Why did it fail? It didn't like this. Invalid behavior if der north. It's already okay. Nah, it's not liking that. East doesn't matter what it is. Oh, is that turning into a letter? That's the problem. Okay, so it's treating that as a letter, a string, instead of it being an integer constant. That's the problem. If it stops, if the sequence is true, yeah. A select will a select stops selecting once it finds a true sequence, a sequence that returns true. So if der north, if that's false, this whole thing is false. How did I learn C++? From books. I learned from books. This was 20 years ago. This is before the internet. So really all we had were books back then. This is before C++ 98. Okay, something's wrong with the parsing of the behavior then, if it's not allowing if that single letter to become an integer, a representation of a behavior enum. So something, we gotta fix this to get this guy working. Behavior parse. We parse the type, we parse values. Type has already been set. Yeah, not really. It wasn't that hard. I mean, yeah, I guess it is hard to compare to today. Today, you guys have so many resources for learning languages and how to develop games. You also have so many tools. It's ridiculous how great the tools are today. The tools back then were non-existent. You had to make your own game from scratch. There were no game engines that were free back in 1994 when I started making video games. There were no video game engines at all, really. There were a few out there, but they were like thousands of dollars to license. for example, Doom, you know, id Software was licensing their engines really early on. There were open source libraries for like Linux and stuff, but not for DOS. This was back before Windows. So all I'm saying is today it is so easy to make video games. It's so much easier compared to then that you guys have it really good. And that's why, that's also why you see an explosion of video games these days. The same thing with music. There's an explosion of music too, because it's easier to make music. How old was I? I was 14 years old when I started learning to program. But even that, there's so many youngins today that are making games much earlier than that. Damn it, why isn't this... All right, let's set a breakpoint. If words I dot size equals one, nice, yeah, nice, right on, man. Good for you, good for you. Awesome. Well, I'm looking forward to what you program, man. So keep me posted on what you're doing. I'm rooting for you. And I think it's awesome that you're programming such an early age. So here we'll break. So what word is this? We got I equals two, word is two. I'm tired of stepping. Let's make that more specific. If word size is one and words I, zero, is east or north or whatever. Let's do north. No, I think I undid north, so we'll do that one. Awesome, man. Yeah, GML's, from what I've heard, GML's a good one to start with too, because it's similar to C-based languages. And I highly think that Game Maker is a good one to start with. For yeah, that's what I just did. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Words is E. What is this going to turn out? Val equals parse value. So it is getting into this function here. Size is greater than zero. Didn't find it. Oh, because it's in the behaviors, not the directions. Oh. Okay, bug solved. Basically, the behaviors tree parser thing needs all this. Oh, see, it has some of them. Okay, yeah, let's just copy these. We need south. South is the S. West, W. Oops. North, east there. Boom. Back to component. We can undo these changes. We just don't need these anymore. Compile, run, should be okay now. Damn. You got stuck there all day? That's a lot of time to get stuck for, man. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, I'm glad. I'm glad that it's a good one to recommend. I haven't used it. I've never used GameMaker. I've used Unity, which is, you know, a lot different, but same kind of concept where it's software that makes a game for you. Oh, he didn't turn the right way. Did he? Oh, okay, so there's one problem. He doesn't know that he should turn right here. So for example, as this guy is walking right here, and there, and there, and there, as he gets to right here, he should know that he needs to turn south and hug that corner, right? He turns south here, and then he hits this, and he goes, oh, okay, and he turns this way, and there, and there, and there, and there, and that's the point of these guys, to hug an edge. So this does need to be a more advanced AI. So what would be a good and simple way to make these guys so they could detect that they need to turn? What's my favorite roguelike? Like just any, even a roguelite? I guess you probably do. Zelda 1. Is that what they're doing? Are they, they're not smashing the grass, are they? Hold on. Let's restart this, because I don't know if they really are smashing that. Oh, no worries, man. I'm making 4 different enemies in one stream. Just the behaviors, though. I'm not working on, graphics for these enemies. Yeah, they're not smashing the grass. That's good. Okay. What's up, the Zirin? Welcome back to the stream, man. Hope you're doing good. How are these enemies different from any other enemies? These guys are going to be different because they hug an edge. Yeah, so the 4 enemies I'm creating today, Blood, are these. A guy that patrols a small area horizontally. A guy that bounces around the screen diagonally. A guy that patrols and shoots 4 diagonal projectiles. And a guy that always stays near an edge. So I'm on this last one right here. This is the very last enemy. All I need to do is get him so he hugs an edge. So for example, if there was an enemy that was one of these guys and he was right next to... For example, this bush. If he was right here next to this bush, all he would do is walk around and around and around and around this bush forever. You know what I mean? Think of Metroid when you're playing the game and it's got those one guys that stay hugged around and around and around and around a platform. That's all. These are dumb enemies. All 4 of these are very dumb enemies. They're just simple enemies that you encounter more at the beginning of the game. Okay, so now I do need to think of a way to get these guys to recognize that they need to turn. How are that? Oh, timer. Yeah, maybe a timer. That could be part of it, right? Every 0.1 seconds or something, it tries turning to the left. Okay, let's try that. That might work. Okay, so it doesn't even need to check if it's stuck. It just selects and then delays. Let's see if that works. How is the ground represented? Is it tiled? No, the ground is not eventually tiled. Here's how it's represented. Oh, see, they get stuck looping around in a circle if they're not near something else. Oh, I guess this could work though. We might be on the right track with this. So, Vlad, you see, they're all rectangles, but they're not tiles. At first, the game does create tiles for everything. So, right? So this is a tile. That's a tile. Everything is a tile. But then when it goes to actually put it into the engine, it converts those into geometric shapes, or actually just rectangles right now. And so a rectangle can be as big as the whole screen if necessary. So yeah, there's tiles, but they're not represented that way as far as the collision engine is concerned. For example, you can see the player's collision box is a lot smaller than this bush right here, which is, the bush is about the size of a tile. The player is a lot smaller. So yes and no. Yes and no. Do they know their position in the world? Yes, but not in the AI. What's up, AnoaNet? All right, so if we do it like this, if we keep this existing sequence, if stuck, and this turn thing, we'll set a timer instead. So we'll like let it run for a whole second or so. Yeah, how's that then? So if so set the timer, and then if the timer is up, and not if we're stuck, but if the timer is just up, then we start this whole thing. So that could put him on the right. Well, what are you talking about though? What's your easy solution for telling if you're on a corner? Because I may be able to integrate it into this somehow. So this should let them run for a whole second before they start doing this. Nope, it didn't. Probably because, oh yeah, because it's already.
One word that comes to mind. I'm streaming.
Risk. Risk.
You can't pucker? Are you going to work today?
Yeah, this could be part of it. Four lines from the middle of the enemy's collision rect. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I got you there. I think this might actually be possible with the current behavior tree system, though. So this sets a timer. Oh, I got it. Okay, wait. Now we don't need this. We can give this guy a target. So if If target none and they're stuck, then we do all this stuff and give them a target. Target nearest friend. And then if, okay, so the turn only happens if you have a target. So if target any, then we could do this. So that way it runs until he gets stuck once, and then he does this thing where he just tries to turn. And this should probably be more like a half second, or maybe a third of a second or something like that. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Does she watch the stream? No, no, she doesn't. She's not really into games or anything like that. Yeah, an edge wreck, yeah. Mm-hmm. Exactly, yeah, yeah. Simple, very nice, I like it. Oh, so they do get stuck because they're... Yeah. Because once they get into that whole zone of staying in that kind of... You know, they get stuck in that kind of thing, so... I guess it might not be possible with this system. Okay, so if it's not possible with that kind of system, then we'd have to do something else. So let me kind of hash out what I would think, what I would want it. They are dancing. Right, just check the perpendicular movement of the, yeah. So if I were to do that, right, let's go with Vlad's method here, simply just drawing, you know, a little ray trace line or whatever. To determine if they need a turn. They've been known to get down. Because they are wild. How are we doing so far on time? Because this is the fourth enemy. I'm kind of getting stuck on this one enemy here. But I think we pretty much got four basic types of enemies sort of done in an hour. That's pretty good. It's 15 minutes per. Alright, so it would go like this. It starts a moving. It like something like this. If has a collision wall, if it has a wall near, if oh, this is pretty simple, actually. If not has a wall to the left, turn left. Right? That's pretty much how this would go. And also it would have to do something like this. This actually, we need a whole sequence to do this. We could just go, if not has a wall, if has a wall nearby, and if it doesn't have a wall to the left, turn left. That's kind of how this would go. So now I got to think of some words that would actually describe all this. Yeah, yeah, exactly. You can't turn left, right? It's like following a maze. You always go to the left or whatever. This is kind of what this guy does. Right? Wouldn't that work? If he has a wall anywhere nearby, And it's not to the left. Turn left. I think that's all there is to this. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay, so we're all in agreement that this is basically a very simple way of making this work. So now it's just a matter of actually creating the words, the keywords, to make this turn into something. So how would I word that and that and that? Well, the last one is pretty simple. I would just want to go dir next. And that would be clockwise. So that would be the right. So actually, I would want to go dir previous. That would be left. That would always be left. Yeah, so if you're facing north, the previous dir would be clock counterclockwise. So that would be west. Yeah, so dir previous. Yeah, yeah. That's why exactly why I have this first one here. If he has a wall nearby, right? So that would make it so he's not going to rotate around in a circle, because right? That requires that nearby wall for, so that first line there is going to make sure that doesn't happen. Ooh, pixel distance maybe? Yeah. But I don't know. I want that to be really, really tight and hugging. So that's a good question. Yeah, I don't know. Would he? Why would he do that? See, okay, so he's going to start walking here. And then once he finds a wall, so this is going to guarantee that he finds a wall nearby. Let's start drawing this, actually. Let's think about this. Here's our wall. If collides edge. Ooh, that's a nice way to write it. All right, ma'am. Good night. If dance party, get down. Oh, great suggestions, guys. If collides edge, it's actually pretty nice there. All right, so let's get... let's think about this. If he starts, he's going this way. Right? This is his initial direction. And he hits this wall. He says, if there's not a wall to the left, turn left. So he would bounce off this. So that would not work. But if he was already on the wall, then it would work, right? So if he's walking, let's say he's walking, well, he's walking, has to go to the left, 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 so he'll be going... He's walking this way. Oh, I got no wall to the left. So he turns. Oh, I got no wall to the left. So he turns. This would work if he's already there. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, so this doesn't work in every case. Yeah, that's the same. That's kind of what we already got here, though. Because the until stuck part This might work here. If you're not colliding with the wall anymore, turn to the direction where the wall was. Right? Let's think about that. All right, man, good night. Yeah, yeah, I agree. So if you're not colliding with the wall anymore, turn to the direction where the wall was. So if that would be like this, if he's already near the wall, He's walking. I'm not sure how he'd be walking. How he'd know that he'd be walking this way. But okay, but anyways, let's go on with it. He gets here and he's like, okay, I'm not colliding with the wall. Wait, what? To the side. If he's not colliding to the side with the wall, then turn in the direction the wall was. Yeah, that would work for that. But let's see if it would work for the going. If you're starting out going this way, you have to, of course, hit a wall first. So, yeah, he'd hit this wall, and he would need his. Okay, I think there might need to be two different sets of instructions. One for when he first hits a wall, and then for continuing along the wall. So I think it might go something like this. Then we need to be a separate sequence for when he's starting out. Yeah, right? We've got that expression. I know, seriously. It's already got some crazy bugs. Right. We've got an impulse vector started. So this could happen, right? He starts off here. He moves. He hits this wall. If it's stuck, oh yeah. So it would just be like this. If stuck, turn left. This would be immediately. I want this to be right. He wants to be right next to that thing. So if the wall is immediately nearby. Okay, let's think about that logic now. He's got two different bits of logic now. Yeah, exactly. Cool. We're on the same page there. Rocket Bunny, this is something you really want to think about down the road. And this is all based on your own style. What do you prefer, you know? You'll get to that point. Learn some GML first. Make some games. Do some tutorials. Understand it enough to the point where you feel very confident. You're accomplished with it, you know? Just nail it. Nail Game Maker until you're so comfortable with it, right? And then make that choice. You'll have grown after that. You'll have grown through that process. and then go experiment with all these, right? Java, C Sharp, or C++. Go experiment with all those until you find one that you really resonate with and you're like, and it's not just going to be the language, it's going to be the tools you're using with that language. C Sharp is very Unity or XNA. C++ is a many different engines. Java is also many different engines. So you're going to want to explore different engines. And you may just find that you just want to learn GML and stick with GameMaker too. So make that call when you get there, I say. Yeah, you don't need this one after you've done that. Right, so it would be more like... if has never been stuck before. And this one would be if has been stuck before. Let's see if that logic works out. Yeah, you're welcome, man. All right, so. Yeah, he's going to hit this wall. He's never been stuck before, so he's going to hit that first sequence. And what's he going to do? If stuck, turn left. Okay, cool. So he turns left, and now he's got a new flag that says, I have been stuck before. So when he's... oh, actually, this might be need to be turned right. So this sequence starts looping right. What's up, professional novice? Yeah, Vlad's got a really good example here. If you can't decide what language you want to do or what engine you want to use, definitely learn C. It's worth learning no matter what to learn C. I recommend starting with it. It's a great, great language to know because so many other languages are C-like. Yeah, there you go. It's a good way to do it. Okay, so when it hits, yeah, I think it needs to be the other way. So hits this wall, turns right. Okay, now he's going down until he gets to this point where there's nothing on the left. So now that he has been stuck before, if it has a wall immediately nearby, true. If it doesn't have one, straight to the left, turn left. All right, this would work, I think, now. So now he's going to turn left, and he's going to get here, and he's going to turn left again. Get here and turn left again. All because he's now ignoring this sequence. And yeah, he should ignore this sequence completely, because even if he gets totally stuck, like for example, if there were another enemy in here that he gets stuck on, you'd want this kind of enemy just to stop. Until that obstacle is cleared. Or walk around the obstacle. But I don't think you'd want him to walk around the obstacle because then he could walk around friends. Like you could get two of these guys stuck just looping around and around and around each other. But that might actually be cool. This is a tricky enemy to create. Yeah. Okay. So this logic could work. Let's try it from a different viewpoint, different everything. Let's get a wall. I guess it really doesn't matter how the wall is, but let's do something weird anyways. Like maybe he starts out right next to the wall. What if he starts right next to the wall? Then, okay, he starts right next to the wall. He gets a random direction. Maybe he walks straight south. He's going, let's make that clear. He starts right about here. He's walking south. He hits this. And he goes, okay, I've been stuck now. So now I can go into my looping mode. So he goes, he turns, if he's stuck, he turns right. The inside corner, yeah, that's a, oh, it's a good thing to check this. Turns right, he walks until he hits this edge. And then, if has been stuck before, if has a wall immediately nearby, not has a wall immediately left. Oh no, I think this guy's gonna break if he goes on this edge now. Because yeah, because he's not going to be able to detect this. Same thing with the inside corner. Yeah, the same. This inside corner might be the exact same kind of situation here. So let's get a different line color. Let's say he starts here. He walks until he hits the wall. He gets stuck. He turns right. Starts going north. If I don't have a wall to the left, turn left. If I don't have a wall to the left, turn left. Yep, it does break right here. So now he's like, okay, I'm trying to go this way, I'm trying to go this way, I'm trying to go this way. Just doesn't work. Oh, it would work if I got rid of this, if it's never been stuck before. Yeah, okay, so if he's stuck ever, turn right. Or that, or that's, or it could clear that flag, right? Yeah, you guys are both saying the same kind of thing here. Or, oh wait, no, you're not. If it's the inside corner, turn the other way. Yeah. So this would be if stuck, turn right. He's like, I'm stuck. I'm turning right. Here, I'm don't have a wall on my left, so I'm turning left. And then he'd be, yeah, it would work. Okay, let's see if that works with this red color now. So he starts out here, he's got this random direction going south. He hits a wall, or what the heck ever, he gets stuck. He goes, okay, I'm turning right. Turns right, hits this wall and gets stuck. He goes, oh, I'm turning right. Same thing. So yeah, this would work. Just walks all the way around and around and around the whole screen. Right, yeah, it is kind of fun, right, to think about this logic of trying to make it as simple as possible, but also work. No, it doesn't change the algorithm. Virtual pizza, huh? Okay, do we even need this has been stuck before? I'm not sure if that one's necessary. Right? It's not necessary for him walking all the way around and around the screen, of course. Let's see if it's necessary for this blue line. Okay, so let's do the same thing again. He starts out here. walks. He's walking, walking, walking. He goes, oh, man, I'm stuck. Turns right. Keeps walking until he's like, oh, I don't have anything on my left anymore. So he turns left. And nowhere during that first time right here does he ever get stuck again. So he's not going to encounter this rule. Wait a minute. Oh, but there's this first part here. If has a wall immediately nearby. You know what? It probably would be the simplest thing if we did this. Instead of writing it this way. If had a wall to the left, and if doesn't have a wall to the left, then turn left, right? That's even simpler. That would make it so it's guaranteed to work over here, because this whole if a wall has a wall immediately nearby is a lot more ambiguous. So it could break, for example, this very first movement. If he goes here and he goes, wow, I have a wall nearby. No, but he would first get this stuck sequence to run. So I guess either one of these would probably work. Yeah, Sorzy, yeah, he does. Mm-hmm. That's why this sequence, if stuck, turn right, is the first part. Yeah, I know, right? Welcome to 30 minutes ago. Was this kind of what it was, right, 30 minutes ago? Probably was, huh? This is different, though, because these are two totally different statements as far as the code goes. But they do seem pretty simple on the outside. Nice, man. I'm glad. Yeah, either way you slice it, I think I like this second one better. If we had a wall to the left, and we don't have a wall to the left, then we don't need to keep track of state, like I've been stuck before or anything, too. All right, so there. That's what it is. That's all there is to it. Okay, so these turn right, turn lefts. This is actually turn right would be dir next. Or I guess we could say clockwise. That might be a little bit more, right? That might be more clear. Clockwise is a lot clearer than previous. Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm, exactly. That's exactly what you said, just worded in a different way. Yep. Had, past tense. You got this. Last line touching past tense. Nice, man. This is a good point. If you're stuck and it has a wall to the left, else turn left. But no, I want him to actually go only clockwise or only counter. So that would allow two different possibilities, right? If you're let's say he's, this would be hard for him to get in this situation, but if he randomly was like up here and started moving to the left, he would just have to go, okay, I'm turning to the right. He would go, go like a millimeter and then turn around and go this way. So that'll keep him always going clockwise, this little bit of code. So, okay, I like this dir clockwise, and this one would be dir counter clockwise. I'm just gonna say dir counter. Okay, so what's a good way? Oh yeah, okay, this is maybe a simple way to word this. If I like going off of what I think was it Vlad, are you saying this? Vlad? Will it be the same if you rotate your wall 180? Yeah, it does. Durr. Nice. How do you say that? How would you say this? How do you pronounce it? If last collision left, if collision no collision, if last collision was to the left, I think I'd probably prefer to write it like that. There we go. That's kind of how it would look. But maybe this word, I'm thinking there might be an easier way to represent that. Oh, you say deer, huh? Yeah, here in the States, we do say direction. 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 Some people say direction, right? Is that wrong? I don't know. Look at me. I'm trying to be the one trying to say how to pronounce things, and I don't know how to pronounce anything. Gradient. 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 Ludum dare. Ludum dare. Oh, like direction? Not always. Mostly dir. We say mostly direction. Right? But it's... Yeah, is that... Ugh. I'm no expert. So the dir clockwise and the dir counter is really easy. If last collision, if not collision, those can be done. Yeah, let's start doing them. How long we got? We got 10 minutes left to try and do this. Let's see how fast this can be done. Last collision. Right. No, this shouldn't be left. This should be clockwise. No, counterclockwise. Is that more intuitive or less intuitive if I make these all short? Now it's kind of looking less, yeah, definitely less. Because it's hard to tell the difference between CW and CCW. So these should be counter. If last collision, counter. If not, collision, counter. This might actually be better if I write a collision, not counter. Yeah. Yep. But we all know that we don't always follow the rules. Yay. Dude, it's so great you got candy for Halloween. I wish I could be young enough to go out and get candy for Halloween. That'd be great. Or how about if a collision not counter? Oh, I don't know, man. Nice. We're a bunch of outlaws, just like the Australians. That's right, Australians. Man, you know what? I'm getting too picky about all this. Just need to do it one way or the other. I kind of want to do it the right way, though. Oh, no. Okay, yeah. This could be totally misconstrued, this statement right here. If collision not counter, that could mean that it's anything, any direction but counterclockwise. So really, that does need to be like if no collision. Yeah. I know, I just tried it though and it wasn't as clear to me. It was easy to gloss over both of these and blur them together. Yeah, you can see the wild cinder blocks. Let's look at the wild cinder blocks a while. This isn't gonna work. Oh, this is gonna break now. Because that sequence. It's gonna be like, I don't know how to do that sequence. So we'll comment all this out. Oh, it's not gonna know dir clockwise either. There we go. We got some clock, some little cinder blocks that are wild, and they're running into each other and getting stuck. What happens if I try and hurt one? That's right. You're hurt now. Oh, you're dead now. Oh, you're not. Your friend's not dead over here, though. Okay, I think it should be more like this. So, if last collision, last frame, we had one counterclockwise. Oh no! This is gonna have to be last frame's counterclockwise. To the current Oh man. Now it's not as simple. I don't know if I like it. What's his blood? Does this have music? Oh, it's Family Guy. Oh, cool. I'll check this out later. Since the quality of the music and everything is all, and the sound of the stream is all great now, I can't really watch as many videos because I get flagged easier on YouTube once I go to upload these to YouTube. Okay, anyways, I think I need to think about this for a minute. I need to get some dinner and take a relaxing break because I keep going back and forth in my head, like maybe it should be like that or maybe it shouldn't be like that, or you know what I mean? So if we're testing the last frame's collision, we need to know what the direction of they were facing last frame was. So yeah, I need to take a break for sure. Well, once I take a break and come back to this, all this will seem more simple, more easy to deal with, and I'll write this code. But anyways, okay, so to recap what got done today, my goal today was to create 4 new enemy types, just the behaviors for them. And we got them. We got a guy that walks, patrols, a guy that walks diagonally, a guy that shoots stuff diagonally, and a guy that's supposed to hug corners, but he doesn't quite do that yet. Direction static, huh? Oh, dude, fail fish. Nice, you type fail fish for me. Is it this one? We're failing to do the fail fish. This is so funny. Oh, there, we both got it. Yeah. Am I coming back today? No, I'll be back tomorrow though. I do 1 stream a day. So, yep. So that's it. That's it for today's stream. Making Songbringer. And tomorrow I'll be, I'm not sure what I'll be doing tomorrow, but catch me tomorrow. We'll see. So stream times are usually 4 p.m. ish, maybe 2 p.m. Pacific time. So catch you guys later.